Hello everyone, in this short tutorial I would like to explain what new features I added AutoRetopology plugin called ZRetopoIt version 2.5. Let's take a look at key features what I added in this release. First one is hotkeys submenu. Now you can quickly assign any hotkey to those buttons. Buttons with S prefix describes organic surface retopology. Buttons with H prefix describes hard surface retopology, as you can see, with keep edges enabled or disabled function. Number is showing which ZRemesher iterations plugin will use for this button. Let's take a look to the Dragon head and see how it works on practice. So I simply create polygroups from paint. Retopology polygrouping is finished. So let's begin retopology with S5 preset. Plugin will do normal polishing on startup. What means normal? Means it will do more polishing on higher iterations and less polishing on lower iterations. So polishing completely depends from mesh poly count. So plugin finished topology and see following rent topology result. We can reduce mesh poly count by pressing the reduce button. Or we can remesh this model with settings again. Just to try to achieve different topology result. This one is quite nice. Let's stay on this one. What other things I want to show you now? Of course, my plugin works with asymmetrical meshes. So, if I scroll back my undo history, and I will delete now part of my topology. I will press now polygroup from paint button to create polygroups. And next I press my close holes button, just to create polygroup around mesh center. Now all polygroups created, we can fill mesh with color. Start doing your topology with disabled symmetry. Let's see what it will do with button. So, are the topology finished? Let's take a look at some results. Relax a little. And we have following topology result. This is the first thing. Next one I would like to show you is how those buttons with age prefix are working. We have hard surface objects like this. We also disabled sim here. Let's retopo this one. I think 5 iterations here will be just fine. We will use hard surface button with age prefix. One thing is the most important is those topology presets buttons are working without any command prompt. And they're working only for selected subtool. I made this for time saving. But if you use that retopo it button, it will work as previous version with all subtools and fully configurable. As you can see, a topology finished, we have result like this. Can we reduce? No, it's pretty cool. Of course we can do it. We can use this button, Z reduce. Done. Much lower poly count and still clean topology, I think. Let's create some creases via crease polygroups button and apply some bevel width. Now we can subdivide this mesh and we have like this. Complete hard surface model with subdivisions, easy to use. I created this mesh via Lightbox Spotlights feature that I described it before in version 2.3 video. Basically how it works. Simple. Hard surface prototyping via alphas. Use star, move this one here. Use snapshot 3D button. After that we can delete this one. We can use another spotlight. Here, start from this, Delete this one. Disable spotlights via Shift Z button. On next step, I go to render booleans, live boolean, make boolean mesh. We can quickly retopo this object via my retopology presets for it or for it. I think for iterations will be good enough. Retopology finished. Let's reduce polycount for this tool. I will simply press Z reduce. And we have polycount like this. Good enough result, I think. We can reduce it even more. And even more. As we can see. Mesh silhouette is still saved. Now we can crisp polygroups, apply some bevels, divide this mesh, we have finished object. We can quickly get hard surface object if we bevel bigger value. Crisp polygroups again, bevel again, smaller value, and divide the mesh again. Now we have stylized edges, emphasized, I think. One of the things that I would like to explain now is new submenus in plugin interface. Main settings and advanced settings submenus. Main settings is the most important and useful things in plugin UI. Basically, this menu you will use every time. That's all what you need to do if you only started working now with my plugin. Settings are self-explanatory. Polish iterate will polish your polypaint after performing the topology. And before performing topology. So, how it works? We can now select some mesh, for example, maybe this cube. Divide it, make polymesh 3D, divide it a couple of times. Delete divisions, and dynamesh it. What we need to use first if you want to create polypaint really quickly? First we will fill mesh with white color. We select black color. We select standard brush. Polypaint polygroup edges with black color. But we have some jagged edges. And we don't know how to enable lazy mouse. Now you can do it with my plugin. You can set Lazy Mouse 4 or Lazy Mouse 1 button. This thing, Lazy Mouse 4, will enable Lazy Mouse with following settings. And mouse average 4. But if I select this button, lazy mouse 1, it will change mouse average input count to 1. Sometimes it's really useful, because if you're zooming out or zooming in to your mesh, you will have some dots, strokes. You can fix this via lazy mouse 1 button if you're having this problem. So your polypaint will always be clean. So lazy mouse 4 is much more smoother, lazy mouse 1 is much more cleaner. That's how it works. Keep Ajax function is hard surface topology feature. You can use this if you want to retopo your hard surface meshes. Created via lightbox spotlights, booleans, or some other stuff in ZBrush. Cleanup iteration is new feature in ZBrush. Basically, it gives you full control when you perform retopology. So, when you're doing retopology, ZBrush will clean your mesh via my plugin. You can adjust when it will start cleaning via this cleanup iteration slider. As you can see, when the retopo it will reach this iteration, it will stop any cleanup operations to save mesh form. So, you are telling plugin, do minimal cleanup operations after you reach iteration. That's why this thing is important, cleanup iteration. Other thing that I would like to show you now is new cleanup topology algorithm via fix triangles and fix advanced buttons. Fix triangles cleans your mesh from triangles per iteration. It's controllable via cleanup iteration value slider here. So when ZBrush will reach iteration number 3, it will stop cleaning your triangles. I mean, after it will reach iteration 3, it will stop cleaning your it will start cleaning your mesh. Why this is important? Because we are always fixing low poly topology from triangles, of course. Let's test this feature, edge cleanup, and fix triangles on Dragon Head. Just scroll back on the history, keep this mesh asymmetrical. We will scroll down this one. And we have some polygroups here. Now let's enable fixed triangles function. Set cleanup iteration to 3, the remesher iterations to 5. And simply press that retopo it button. As you can see, the retopo it showing you some windows that it will now perform retopology, because we are using the retopo it button instead of hotkeys button. So, what we have now? See, we have now much more cleaner topology result. Without almost any topology errors. Of course, we can now try to reduce smash per account. Yeah. Hot case is reduced. And we have topology result like this. That's all I think for this update. I hope this information was really useful for you. Thank you for following and have a nice day as well. Thank you so much for your support.